no matter where you are, you shine in the heart of the sunrise. In the city lights over mountains high, valleys filled with noise, under silver moons and desert dunes, peaceful autumn shores. Oh, no matter who you are, you shine in the heart of the sunrise. Oh, 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 oh. In the weeping eyes, hungry cries, victims of each war, is it peace and love and harmony what we've been fighting for? Oh, so maybe one day, before it's too late, we will all realize that no matter who you are, you shine.
I learned pretty quickly on this project that writing music for hip-hop is all about the uniqueness of the beat. And as I was looking for new rhythms and sounds, I remembered back to the days when I was in the marching band on Long Island, when the most powerful beats came from the drum line.
Yeah.
This is 18-year-old Julia Eichten from Stillwater, Minnesota. She's been dancing since she was 4 years old and competing since she was six. At the moment, she won the principal dancing position for our Alive project. She also found out that she would be entering the Juilliard School as a freshman. 25-year-old Lee Foad, a.k.a. Breeze Lee, originally studied the art of karate. A two-time karate national champion, Lee has taken the discipline he learned as a karate master into the world of hip-hop dance. The idea for our next song was to take Julia and Lee and create a dance for them that would showcase their unique talents, while at the same time, give them a chance to stage a little dance war for our audience. Along the way, these two unique dancers became close friends. And although technically they come from two vastly different worlds of dance, it's pretty clear they share a mutual respect.
What she does as a lyrical dancer, it's unbelievable. She's putting her body to the limit in terms of her style, her dance, and it's just beautiful to see.
I had no idea what to expect because the hip hop where I come from is what they call like very choreographed and really tight, and theirs is more movement with the body, and I've never seen anything like it before.
So when I saw her, I gained so much more respect. I already had respect, but I was just like, after I saw her, I was like, she's amazing. She has a bright future ahead of her. I only wish her the best after this. I know she's going to Juilliard, which I know is very difficult to get in, so I gotta give her a lot of props on that.
It's great to see a whole different side of hip hop that I've never seen, and their level of dance is unbelievable.
Thank you. friendship.
Julia Eichten, Christine Miller.
Our biggest purpose for creating the Alive Project was to showcase kids living out their passion for dance, and in the process, perhaps encouraging other kids to do the same. We live in a world right now where 1 in 5 children in North America is overweight. In fact, childhood obesity is now officially an epidemic. Getting girls and boys into programs that encourage an active lifestyle can change all of that, but it must be something they are truly passionate about. Here and now are 5 girls, ages 13 to 15, who live out their passion every day after school in the dance studio. Here they are, dancing to Beginnings.
Silencio tu adonis, te lo dones te
Carly Magnificat, and they are there. Well done, ladies. Bethany, Elizabeth, and Roxanne.
Martha Graham once said, "Dance is the hidden language of the soul." And Albert Einstein was quoted as saying, "Dancers are the athletes of God." A lot of this show is built around a gentleman that I met quite by accident. You know, as a father, mother, when you drive your kid to dance class, especially a 12 or 13 year old, your biggest job is to run after you drop them off, because the kids don't want any part of you. Amen to that? Yeah, you got to get out of there. And one day, I said, I got to figure out what this hip hop. My daughter is taking hip hop. What is that all about? So, I hid in the back and I watched this teacher, Breeze Lee, teaching these 8, 9, 10, 15, 16-year-old kids how to dance. I think this is a varsity football workout. This is the best workout I've ever seen. Kids are sweating, and they're all ripped, and they're in such great shape. And I'm watching this guy dance, and I'm thinking, well, I thought hip-hop was, you know, you sort of like this on the ground, you spin around a couple of times and hold your hat, you know? I thought that was hip-hop. But he's doing this stuff, and it's called popping. I come now to know that it's called popping and locking and strobing. I was like, I've never seen anything like that. So after the class, I walk in, and my daughter's like, oh, Dad, get out. And I said, hey, listen, I just was watching you do this stuff, and I'm thinking, would you like to, we have a concert this weekend, would you like to come and dance with our band? And he goes, well, who are you? And I said, never mind that, just come and dance, it's going to be a lot of fun. So he did, he's been a member of the band ever since, for the last year or so, and thrilling audiences with his style. Please welcome Mr. Breeze Lee. Now, what you have to understand about, oh, I have to do our secret handshake first of all, yeah, rainbow, okay. What you have to understand about, I'm in like half the club. You have to understand about Breeze Lee is that, you know, on stage, if we hear a song, we might translate it into chords on a piano or on a guitar or a pitch in your voice or on the violin. But when he hears music or sound, it becomes part of his body. His body reacts. For example, if I was to do this horrible imitation of a beatbox rapper, he would probably
hopefully, react to that. So it's like being at SeaWorld, isn't it, ma'am? or if he's walking through his apartment, and there's the news is on, and the helicopter traffic report is on, he might react to that. You know, well, I was a fender bender on the I-70. Well, what about if he's walking down the street and a lovely girl catches Breeze Lee's eye? Thank you for indulging me. I've only got half a lung left, so let's try this with music. Nate, light us up here. Let's add some bass to this, Tim. We'll be right back.
please leave.
The Alive Music and Dance Project was truly built around the dancers. And of course, one of our principal dancers is Breeze Lee. One of the reasons this guy is my hero is that he spends most of his time off the stage using his talents to teach and encourage kids to get up off the couch and step into a life of passion and discipline. The hundreds of hours that Lee and his crew put into choreographing and rehearsing the dance numbers for Alive hardly compare to the years of service he has put into working with kids in his tiny dance studio. What he teaches is the joy of movement, and there's a lot of that. If you sign up for a Breeze Lee dance class, be prepared to burn a few thousand calories. Lee says most people call it hip-hop, but he says it's a combination of dance styles, including strobing, popping, and locking, and sometimes even a bit of ballet.
I do a lot of popping. That's just one of my favorite styles under the hip-hop umbrella. Hip-hop has a lot of styles under it. Popping is my favorite. It's something that I've clicked to ever since I started dancing. You feel the whole body and you're trying to pop your arms, your biceps, your chest, your legs, your neck, your head. You're trying to just like look like a dancing robot, you know, but to the extreme.
Mm-hmm.
Reese Lee and Versastyle.
Give it up.
Working with the kids on the Alive Project was an amazing experience for all of us. And in the middle of auditioning ballet dancers, we came upon 18-year-old Julia Eichten from Stillwater, Minnesota. Julia had just been accepted as a freshman to the prestigious Juilliard School in New York. And we soon realized that while she excelled in classical ballet, Julia's ability to ad-lib is what made this next song come alive.
Julie Eichten. Bravo, Julie. Christine Miller on vocals. Tim Landers, fretless bass.
The Alive Music and Dance Project is easily the most ambitious concert event I've ever been involved in, and the most fun. Working with all these young dancers ages 13 and over and the finest musicians in the land, our group mission was to create a project that would inspire kids and adults to go find their passion in life. Dance has a way of making everyone who experiences it come alive. And I know that everybody on this team of over 300 will carry this spirit with them forever. The rehearsals for Alive were long and complicated because, unlike most of the TV specials we've created in the past, these songs had to not only work musically, but they also had to fit with the style and the tempo of the dancers. And whether it was orchestra or choir, the performers put in hundreds of hours of rehearsal to make sure the live television taping and CD recording would be flawless. What I love most of all, the young ballerinas. So inspiring to watch these kids and their dedication living out a dream.
And listen to the music, because it's live now. It's not definite counts like we had. It's going to be different every time. So every time you hear it now, it's going to be different. That's the way it is with live music.
Yeah, we got serious, but there was also a lot of fun. Two of the choreographers, Breeze Lee and his mom, Johnette Swider, auditioning for Dancing with the Stars. And I got educated. I now know that real dancers don't just dance when you ask them to. They dance all day and all night. And even if they have a disagreement, they don't shout, they don't raise a fist. They do something called battling, where they use their technique in the studio, in the gym, or on the streets to decide who has the last word. And although it's unlikely our world leaders will decide matters dancing to the music, the fact that kids are doing it is a great start. When I learned about this part of the hip-hop culture, I wrote a song for our dancers to give them an opportunity to show you what I've been seeing in rehearsal all week. Watch now as our dance troupe takes sides so you can decide who comes out on top. Stand by. This next song is called The Showdown. At this point in the Alive program, we'd like to throw down a challenge. After spending so many weeks with these wonderful dancers, all of us, musicians and crew members, were inspired to get up off the couch and get some serious exercise. We also came to learn that the movement inside dance is not just exercise. It's truly a metaphor for life. And that's the message with which we leave you today. Whoever you are, whatever you're doing, It's time to get passionate about your life. It's time to move from the place you are right now to the place you were meant to be. It's time to dance.
I'm
You guys want to say hello one more time to these great dancers we've seen this evening? Ballet Magnificat! The Johnette Swider Junior Ballet Company. Breeze Lee!